everyone on my Patreon site. New readings just for our Patreon patrons, and thank you so much to those who contribute every month. And I'm glad now that I have new guidance to expand on the Patreon page. Because really what I was up doing was uploading from YouTube every now and again, and you know, I could have been given more. So here we are. I'm going to do this soulmate divine partnership reading. Whenever you trip across it, it's the right time for you if you're coming on stream as a new patron. And for those that are here already, take it for now and our forward movement into the near future. So I'm going to choose two from Doreen Virtue's Romance Angels deck. Give them a good shuffle here. Two, there's one. And there is two. Very interesting. Okay, romantic feelings. The feelings you're feeling are real and worth following up on. Your feelings are real and worth exploring. So since this is a divine partnership soulmate reading, it's romantic. So if you are feeling romance, attracted to some person, your feelings at this moment are real and true. From someone who has walked this path, and for the last 9 years, I've been walking my path in a new way and learning more things. And what I've learned is that we change, other people change, our feelings change, our opinions change, our paths change. So this is for this moment. If you are feeling romantically connected with another being, your feelings are real and worth exploring. Let go of the outcome, because we have no idea where we're going, but we've got to feel our feelings, process them, and move forward. What is your next right step? One step at a time, baby steps. And the outcome, if you want your physical wedding, you are walking towards it. If you want a spiritual partnership, you are walking towards it. It may or may not be this person you're feeling romantically connected to at the moment. But you've got to follow your feelings, because you're going to learn and you're going to grow through them. So let go of the outcome, but keep it general if this is what you're looking to do. Also, along this path of following your feelings, you're going to marry yourself. You're going to find yourself, and you're going to be your best partner. Okay, this situation involves marriage. Okay, so we talk about physical marriage. Are you in a marriage, a real physical marriage? Do you need to be there, or a relationship? Do you need to feel your feelings and let go? Or do you need to feel your feelings and expand and grow on them and bring in more love to this relationship? I know in relationships there are two people involved, but you can only be you. You can only follow your path. You can only feel your feelings. So do your work, and this will come to you, or this will get better. You know your feelings. You got to follow them. Okay, so follow your feelings. Feel your feelings. Let go. Expand, grow, don't worry about it, just feel those feelings and process them. Try not to go into fear mode, it won't serve you too well, but we've all done it, we've been there. Follow process, get help if you need it, and this is where you're going, in whatever shape or form you want it to be or look like, whether it's just being a fuller version of yourself and marrying yourself, or whether you want the physical marriage or just the physical soulmate connection. So this is your path and you're going to get there. Just make it a little easier on yourself. These, the little Tony Carmine Salerno's Lover's Oracle deck. And just choosing two from there with regard to this relationship or any relationship around you as to what you need to do or how you need to look at it. Keep them all this way. This one. So this one, beautiful picture, take from it what you will, blue energy, throat energy, but there's also purple here, so it's all the chakras really, again, the upper chakras. Sexual union, honor the place in one another where you are one eternal soul, for there you will find true bliss. So we're all connected. And it doesn't really matter what relationship we're talking about here, but it seems to be the romantic one that we've been talking about with our romance cards. We're all mirrors for each other. We all are one. So whoever it is at the moment, honor them as a soul on a journey as well. See them as your mirror and take turns in supporting each other and helping each other to grow and expand. It's not the old way of he should be doing this to give me love. He should be bringing me here or there or everywhere. This is soul stuff. It's soul love, which will come into the physical, of course, too. And just look at it as supporting one another, helping each other grow, and not taking things personally, not taking their actions personally. The Four Agreements is a book, and one of the agreements is don't take things personally. Okay, and two people in this card again, and we're talking about from the solar plexus up this time, and playfulness, so fun, keep it light. Laughter is the best therapy. Have some fun together and remember, love is the greatest healer. So feel those feelings. Whatever feelings bring love within you, feel them. Love is the greatest healer. Have fun. Lighten up. It is a journey that we took on before we came here. But make it as easy on yourself as possible. Don't take things personally. Have some fun and vibrate your vibrations at a high level. Even turn on a comedy and look at it and laugh, even if you're not together with this person. Okay. Now what I want to do is choose one for the masculine energy and one for the feminine energy. Understanding. Too many gone. I think I'll pick them up and put them in again. Understanding that we've got male and female within each of us. Masculine and feminine within each of us. These are Tony no, they're not. They're John Holland's Psychic Tarot for the Heart cards. Okay, just have a thought, and if it happens, I'll let you know. Okay, I want to see what that one is jumping up there, but it's not the one I, okay, and this one, right. Okay, I will use the three of them. So the crown chakra, remember I mentioned the chakras already and the upper chakras. So we're receiving guidance through the crown chakra. Number seven, you're on the right path. So quiet time, receive that guidance, wear the color purple, bring purple into your life, or just focus on that card. So receiving guidance in through the crown chakra, divine higher guidance from your higher self, feel your feelings, receiving the guidance. And we're being shown that isolation and sadness, all the lower feelings are a springboard to higher consciousness. Number three, mother, father, God, male, female, connecting with the higher energy. So there is no separation. We are all connected. We are all one. Okay. So sadness and isolation, even if you feel it, let it go. Just know it's a springboard to higher stuff. And listen to that guidance coming in through the heart chakra. And finding balance. During our journeys, we go low and we go high. As we move forward and we grow and expand, we find more balance. We feel that the lows aren't as low and they don't knock us. We don't get knocked for a week on the floor and can't move. So finding balance is the journey. And just know that if you're in a low place or a high place, don't be too high, and the low will springboard you higher. But just not to get run away with the higher level stuff and not to get too knocked with the lower level stuff. But it's a journey, it's a process, so take care of yourself through it all. Find balance. Now, the first one was the masculine energy, and the second one was the feminine energy. So the feminine energy is finding balance, nearer balance. The masculine energy is drawing in the higher consciousness from the higher self. So if masculine and feminine are in the one body, of course, as they are, this is what's happening within us all. And this was just the added message about the sadness and the isolation. It's a springboard. So not to look at it, not to be judging yourself when you're down here. Just know this too shall pass and you're going to grow and expand and move up because of it. So love and light to you all. I will upload this video, and when I feel the need again, I will upload another one on something or other. I did say that I will bring in more of my personal journey into the Patreon videos, because I don't want to share too much on the public arena at the moment, because my twin flame is a hugely private person, and I have my children to think of, and my personal family as well, so it'll be bit by bit by bit. So for now, I'll be sharing bits and pieces of my personal journey here through the Patreon videos. So thank you all again for your help, and I'll be back during the week, please God.